Hello creative designers and welcome on to this story. My name is Peter and on today's story we're just going to see how we can use Elementor and create an image, and on hover it just shows text. We're just going to create this header here, this text here, an image, and we're also going to add this social icon. We're also going to have this one with no background, and on this one when you just hover it even change the background. That's the tutorial for today. We're just going to use Elementor, and I'm just going to also offer you some CSS code which you can use for you to get into this final result. And without further ado, let's just get into action and I show you how. So the first thing we just need to do, we need to add some column. You're just going to add these three column here, and upon adding them you just need to just set the content to full width. And from there, we're just going to set the height to fit the screen. With that, now we have been able to create this section. So from there, we are also going. The next thing we just need to do, we just click on this Rubik box icon here, and we just need to drag in a section. And with that, just delete the one of them so that we can have one inner section. So from there, click on this outer this edit column. So you're going to edit the outer column here. On click here, we just need to set some few things. So just click on advance, and I'll link this because you need to add some margin. And left on this light margin, we just need to set it to about something like a 16 here, and on left you need to add something like 50. So from there, we just need to get to the inner column. So we need to edit the inner column. Just go to advanced and you need to add a margin of 20%, like 20 pixels, like that. So from there, we are good to go. So the first thing we just need to do, we have the title here, and we have the text, and we have these icons, and we have the image. So we need to set all of them. So the first thing we just need to do is we add a heading here. We're just going to call it profile one, like that. You can set it on the center, you can set the alignment to where you want. The other thing we need to get to style, and you can just add some text here, and I'm just going to use something like colors, like that. First of all set some topography here, and I'm just going to use the family font for Poppins here, and I'm just going to use something like 25 here, unless you can use something even like 40, depending on how you just want to, but I'm just going to use 40, and I'm just going to add some weight of 900, and I want to transform to capitalize. So from there I just need to add some text here. So I just come here and drag text editor. And upon having it, I want to have a 7 line. So here, I just come here and I say I want to cut it from that end there. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that. And I can add something like that also. And I can put it to an end here, and then I delete all other. So I have now 7 lines. So let me customize here. I add it to bold, and I can come here to style. I want to have text color. Let me just first of all leave it the way it is. You can come to topography and set your font. I'm just going to use Poppin, and I'm just going to use something like 18 here, and I want to have 900 as my width. Decide to customize the line height depending on how you just want to use it. So from there I'm just going to use to add something called social here. So you can add as many as you can. Let me just add LinkedIn, like that. So from there I'm just going to only use, you can customize and add maybe a button here, or you can use maybe this icon depending on how you just want to use it. So I click here, and then I want to use the official color here. I want to have a shape is loaded like that. And the column you can use, I want them to be auto column, and then the alignment I want it to be on the center. So I come to style here. You can increase some size for them. Yeah, but I'm just going to use 18 here. And I can add a padding of 0.9. So 0.9 like that. And so you can increase some padding here, 0.9 like that. And you can also increase some spacing in between them. Let me use 15 here. And you can increase the row gap here. And it's not changing. So from there, we're having something good. So from there, whatever you just need to do now is we add an image. So I drag an image and I drop it here. And upon I need to select the image I'm going to use. Let me select this one here. I insert it like that. So with that, we have now created all those elements that we just want to have. So you can add some effect before you add the CSS. So I just come here and I just select icon hover and I say I want it to bounce out like that. You can add so many, all those effects that you just need to have. So from there, all we just need to do is we add the CSS. And remember, for you to be able to add the CSS, you need to have the Elementor Pro version. I have included my affiliate link. You can use it to get the Elementor. You're using my Elementor affiliate link, you'll not be charging anything more, but I'm just going to earn some commission, which will help me to continue creating this content. So for now, we have just select the inner section, this one here. After that, it has been highlighted. Just click on advanced, select custom CSS. I include the link on the description on where you can get the link. So upon you getting here, scroll now to where you have the CSS to use. So I just copy all this one here. I copy, and with that, I just go back here and I click here and I paste it. So upon paste it, nothing happened. So what you just need to do, we need to add some CSS classes. I have included them here, so we just need to scroll down here and we have the CSS classes, and I'm just going to show you how where to be placed on and on how you can place it. So we just come here and just click on here and select advanced here, and we need to add the CSS class for this one. This one is the card, use the small letter. And the other thing, we just need to do all these other elements from here to here. We're just going to give them the class name as card content. So I just come here and go to advanced and I select CSS classes and add card content called underscore content. Just come here and paste, copy the way they are, just like that. I just copy it and then I come now, I paste, you see, now it just disappeared. So I just select on content here. I just go to advanced and I paste my CSS class, and I come to the social icons here, and I just need to add the CSS class. All those features that you want to be hidden until you hover on it, just give them this CSS class. Then from there, we just come here to the image that we're going to have. I select advanced and I go to CSS class, but this one will be different from the other one. We're just going to call it card image. This is the one we just want to have. So I paste it here, and now you see we have it working well for us. So whatever just happened is that when we just added some CSS, everything has been highlighted. Like for this one is card image, the one we have just added, that this one is working for the image. You can, if you want to add some, maybe some width, you can just come here and add something like that. So, but I just want to give it the way it is for now. So from there, we just need to just come here on this outer column here. So I duplicate 2 times. So then I delete this one and I also delete this one. So now we have these 3 columns. Remember, on the one we had one with the gradient, and one we have on hover, it just changed the background. So what you just need to do is I just come on this second one here. I just select the inner column here. and I go to style and I set the background as gradient, and then I come here. You can choose any color you just want to have as your gradient. So I just come here, then I want it to be darker on the edge. So from there, and other thing I want it to be out like that. So from there, we just need to customize everything back here. So I just need to select on the profile and just come to here and like just give it a different color. Then I come here for the text, I just come to style and I offer different color for that. Just look good for that. You see, now just look amazing. The other thing we just need to set is the one that on hover, it just changed the background. So what you just need to do is I just select the inner section. I come to style and I select here on hover and I select the background. You can add some gradient or you can use a single color. So I just select one color here. Let me use this one and see how it look. That look amazing. You can customize the way you just want to have. And after that, just need to do is you just update. Let me just show you something unique here. I can just come here and I select on image here. Then I go to see, let me just select this inner section here and I go to CSS. Then I scroll to almost the final bar image here. Then I select the width here to about some 350. Then on hover, you see, it just comes small. And I can also move here and add something 300. You can see you can have as wish. You can preview the setting and on this one card on hover, the way the image will just be. So I can just say like, let me just use something like 600 and see whatever it happened. It can go beyond 400 pixel, but 400 pixel works good. So but the way you can just do it very minimal way. The other thing I just want to share before I conclude is that depending on how you just want to customize your page, you can decide to have this one as minimum. So you can just click here and come here to height and set minimum height, and with that you can see it just look amazing for that. Yeah, it just look very good for that. You can be able to customize in there and you can add other content here, this one, and good content, and change here to content 2, and then select on this text here and come here and change everything here and just offer something, whatever the information you just want to share. Just edit like that and remember to update for you to see the effect. So I just need to change also this one and I just update. So from there, now we have it. This is whatever you have just created on this tutorial. Just look amazing. You can just try it on your time. You can just customize and you can just preview the setting here and there. If you see like for this one, you can just add a single line and it may improve, it may change the way everything look like here. That's the tutorial for today. I hope you didn't learn something out of this tutorial. If you really learned something out of this tutorial, hit the thumbs up. Remember to subscribe to this YouTube channel if you're new here. Till next time, thank you.